Across America, railroad roundhouses used to be a very common sight. These buildings, created specifically for the maintenance and upkeep of steam locomotives, were ubiquitous. After all, during the height of the steam locomotive era, there were more than 1,000 railroads needing service on more than 100,000 steam locomotives. A circular structure with a turntable in the center, those are the defining characteristics of a roundhouse. According to Trains Magazine, there were once 3,000 of these buildings across North America. Today, that number has dwindled to fewer than 200. Wikipedia lists just a dozen operational roundhouses still in use in North America. We're in the Bob Julian Roundhouse. It's the largest roundhouse remaining in North America, and it's located right here at the North Carolina Transportation Museum in Spencer. This roundhouse was built in 1924, has 37 stalls, and a 100-foot electric turntable in the center. These days, it houses exhibits full of railroading and even aviation history. It's still a functioning railroad maintenance and restoration facility as well. While these days it's primarily diesel locomotives moving on and off the turntable, notable steam locomotives have also been restored here, including the Virginia Museum of Transportation's N&W Class J No. 611 and the Atlanta History Center's Texas locomotive. Starting back in 1924, workers would begin their day here in the clerk's office, receiving their orders before the work began. A typical roundhouse was used for light maintenance, work that could take 2 days or less, the sole purpose being to get a locomotive at the end of its running cycle and prepare to get back onto the rails. For heavy repair and restoration, locomotives would be sent to the back shop. Now, roundhouses varied greatly in size, depending on the needs of the railroad. Small roundhouses in outlying areas may have only 3 or 4 stalls, while railroads in larger cities would have cathedral-esque buildings constructed to keep their engines moving. Roundhouses were buildings with a very specific purpose, and when diesel engines took over for steam, the era of the roundhouse largely came to an end. But these buildings left a lasting impression. Railroads were essential to moving people, goods, and raw materials across the nation. They built roundhouses where they were needed, and as Trains Magazine put it, civilization would follow. Major cities grew up around railroad terminals that kept locomotives moving. A town in the Piedmont of Georgia called Terminus grew into the modern-day city of Atlanta. Chicago was a transportation hub, and the city grew around it. Since the end of the steam locomotive era, most roundhouses have been torn down, but some have been repurposed. The B&O Railroad Museum, for example, has their restored railcar maintenance roundhouse. It's a centerpiece of their museum and was formerly part of the Baltimore and Ohio Railroad. Former Chicago Bear Walter Payton actually purchased a roundhouse outside of Aurora, Illinois. He restored it, and these days, it's home to a micro pub, an event and banquet space. So there are still some roundhouses left. Come see the largest remaining, the Bob Julian Roundhouse, right here at the North Carolina Transportation Museum in Spencer. And here are some of the other roundhouses still left across America. Continue to learn at home with other great videos from the North Carolina Transportation Museum on Facebook, YouTube, and nctrans.org. The North Carolina Transportation Museum in Spencer is the museum that moves you.